Hey everyone, you might have surmised from the past two videos that this channel is on a bit of an ASUS and Alder Lake streak of late. Continuing in a similar vein for today's video, we'll be checking out the ASUS ROG STRIX Z690-I Gaming Wi-Fi, a mini ITX offering from ASUS sporting the top-of-the-range Intel Z690 chipset that supports Intel's 12th generation Alder Lake processors. Before we begin, big thanks to my friends over at Monster Computers who have lent me this board for the video. Do check them out if you're on the lookout for a custom-built PC in Singapore. And with that, let's get cracking. Being from the Republic of Gamers lineup, the Z690i sports a great-looking black and red color scheme that looks pretty premium. And if we were to move over to the rear of the box, some highlighted features include a 10+1 power delivery solution, a vertical riser card for SATA ports, RGB and front panel headers so as to save space in your PC case, and the inclusion of dual Thunderbolt 4 ports, which is a pretty high-end feature to have. As you can see, the Z690i comes with quite a number of accessories, starting with a Wi-Fi antenna with a magnetic base, two SATA tree cables, a spare M.2 Q-latch attachment. The Q-latch feature by ASUS allows you to install M.2 SSDs without needing screws, and I guess it's a pretty cool feature to have. Apart from this, we get a front panel USB 2.0 Y-splitter cable, and this is accompanied by a front panel header extension cable. Now, both these cables allow you to get around tight spaces in your ITX case. Apart from that, we also get a pack of cable ties and a vertical riser card in this little box here, which we'll cover later in the video. Apart from these, we also have the usual guides and manuals, as can be seen here. It also includes a DVD driver disc and a little thank you card from ASUS. Also included is a sheet of ROG stickers, which look pretty nice. And to round off, we have a ROG keychain included as part of the packaging as well. Onto the board's aesthetics, it has a grey and black colour scheme going on that looks par for the course of a board from the ROG lineup, with a good measure of ROG motifs throughout. One thing that really stands out is the stack of heatsinks and PCBs that hold the board's M.2 slots, which gives the board a rather chunky and distinctive appearance, I would say. For power delivery, the board guns for a 10+1 configuration and has a 10-layer PCB, which I guess is to be expected since this is a premium board after all. Given the board's compact design, ASUS has also thrown in a small cooling fan for the VRM heatsink, which is integrated with the rear I/O shield area. We've also got some ROG marketing going on here. I'm not even going to try pronouncing the first line of text on the shroud, but this is in apparent reference to the Republic of Gamers marketing lore. The Z690i comes with two DDR5 slots in a single tab configuration, with support for up to DDR5 6400 speeds. Next to the slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header, as well as a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C front panel header. Owing to the limited real estate on the board, ASUS has gone for a vertical riser arrangement to house 4 SATA 3 ports, an addressable RGB header, as well as a front panel header. And this riser attaches to these two connectors that look sorta like male USB-C connectors. You do have the option of not installing the riser card, in which case the only front panel connector you can connect would be the power button header located right here on the board. Onto this heatsink and PCB sandwich of sorts, removing this heatsink here reveals one of the two PCIe 4.0 X4 M2 slots that are included with this board. And here we have it, the first PCIe 4.0 X4 M2 slot. To gain access to the second M2 slot, which is located beneath this PCB, you're going to have to undo this cable as well as these screws to remove the PCB on which the first M2 slot is mounted on. And with the screws out of the way, here's the module on which the first M2 slot is mounted on. As you can see, it's sort of like an integrated heatsink design. And beneath it, here we have it, the second M2 slot. Being a mini ITX board, the Z690-I comes with a single PCIe 5.0 x16 slot with the ASUS safe slot feature, which reinforces the slot so as to allow it to support heavier graphics cards. Audio for this board is powered by the higher-end Realtek ALC4080 audio codec, which is accompanied by a Savitek SV3H712 amplifier chip. For internet connectivity, ASUS has included 2.5 gigabit Ethernet powered by Intel's I225V and Wi-Fi 6E courtesy of Intel's AX210. For fan headers, the board comes with 3 of them, and they are located in these areas of the board. In terms of RGB support, one addressable RGB header as well as a single 12V RGB header are integrated directly onto the main board itself. Do note that there is actually support for a second addressable RGB header, but this is only available if you have the vertical riser card installed. Onto the rear I/O ports, the Z690-I comes with a single HDMI 2.1 port, two USB 2.0 ports, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, 3 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, 2 Thunderbolt 4 USB Type-C ports, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports. It also includes Wi-Fi antenna connectors and a BIOS flashback button that allows you to update the BIOS without needing to install a CPU or RAM. It also includes a clear CMOS button as well as the standard array of audio jack connectors. In conclusion, the ROG Strix Z690-I is a feature-packed mini ITX board that can most certainly serve as a solid backbone for a high-end Intel 12th generation Alder Lake PC, boasting quite a fair bit of engineering to deliver a serious set of features in a small package. It does, unfortunately, come with a hefty price tag as well. As of January 2022, this board can be had at around $439 from Amazon or Newegg. While this next factor is by no means any fault on ASUS's part, sky-high DDR5 prices at the present moment are also likely to significantly increase the costs of using this board in a PC build. With that, thanks so much for watching. Do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, and I hope to catch you guys around the next time.